So next we are going to welcome Agis Zizimato. He has quite an active role in the LibreSpace community as a hardware designer. He's worked on the ground segment side and on the flights on the space segment side, looking at the rotator on the ground segment, and then looking at the design for the OBC and the ADCS system on UPSat. So he's going to give us an overview of the lessons learned, highs and lows, of the ADCS system for the UPSat mission. Over to you.
Hi. My name is Agis. And I want to warn you about my bad English, so this is a check for go, no go. So go or no go?
It's okay, we don't hear you.
Okay. Okay. I think it's better to use this. I want to use this.
Okay. Yeah. Go ahead.
So, again, I want to warn you about my bad English. So this is a check about go and go, no go to the presentation. So
go!
I will try to explain about the lessons that I learned of development of ADCS and what the ADCS is and does. ADCS is the attribute determination and control system. Controls the rotation of the satellite and how to control this, control the rotation. It wants to know about the determination, so the rotation velocities. Sorry, I'm nervous. It wants to know about the angular velocities. The mission that is used is required a pointing accuracy of 15 degrees, a knowledge accuracy of 5 degrees, and recovery from tip-off rates up to 10 degrees per second within 2 days. It's necessary to describe the body frame of a satellite. The x-axis is in the axis of velocity. The z-axis pointing to the Earth, wants to pointing to the Earth, and is in the axis of the camera that placed here. And in the x-axis, we are put a reaction wheel that is placed here. And the roll pitch yaw is X, Y, and Z. The note down here. Okay. System architecture. First of all, the system chooses what kind of controller wants to run, a dedoubling or pointing. A dedoubling controller reduces the angular velocities, and if the conditions is less, the angular velocities in each axis is less than 0.23 degrees per second, then switching to the pointing controller. This is the control system. Here is the controller, the dedoubling or pointing. The actuators of the system is two magnetotorquers in X and Z axis, and one spin torquer in Y axis. Then the control loop closed by the sensors and the determination algorithm. The sensors in the system is two magnetometers, is two different technologies. One technology is inductive and the other is resistive, MEMS, MEMS that calculates or measures the magnetic field of the Earth in body frame, a gyroscope that measure the angular velocities in body frame, a sun sensor that is placed in Z minus side, right here, there, and a GPS that produces the position and velocity in Earth center inertial frame, and a temperature sensor to compensate the offsets of gyroscope. Another specifications of the ADCS is the control loop time, how the controllers switch the conditions, and the power consumption. known issues before flight. First of all, the first thing is the limited time of, for development and testing. The first commit was done in 26 April, and last commit was done in 16 August. Not too many months for development and testing for a subsystem. Total research, when we have we had an overnight test to 12 hours, we have four research.
Please stay close to the microphone.
Okay, sorry, we have four total research in overnight test. As you can see there, we can see the C stick of the time of each subsystem. The blue one is ADCS, and this is that only makes research. And let's see why we have this research. First of all, we can explain the ADCS reset with blue points. That we have two resets. Reset source is it means reset source when the ADCS resets. After the reset, we can read about what caused the reset. Reset 7 means that the ADCS is closed from EPS, and the reset 18 means that the ADCS is closed from a watchdog timer. Why we have these two kinds of resets? We have this because the I2C bus blocking my speed token communication, and when the I2C bus is blocking, we have made a mechanism that the watchdog timer is not refreshed because the software reset of I2C wasn't working. So we not refresh the watchdog timer, and then a watchdog timer kick the MCU in order to reset, and the communication with sensors and spin torques starts again. Also, we can see that the ADCS boot counter is not stored correct, because if you can see the green dots, you can see, and when we have one reset, then it measures a lot of, because the store of this counter is not implemented correctly in the flash memory. It's not stored correctly. Okay. The bigger one of issues that is not shown in before slides and diagrams is the GPS never fixed position, got fixed position in test campaign. And this is a problem in the determination part of the ADCS. Let's see about the orbit life. In order to analyze the orbit life of ADCS, we have limited external whole orbit data. That is 8 packets from almost 200 whole orbit data of the time of period of almost 1 year. That is the life of UPSat. In this diagram, we can see the boot counter that is not working correctly because it starts from a reset counter 100 and something and reduce instead of increased. And also we can see about the transmission error and the reset source also, that this one, it was done because the ADCS is not synchronized the time with the OBC, so the determination algorithms never start to work. Okay, there's two diagrams about the uptime and the time difference between the OBC and the ADCS, which is 26.5 seconds. That is not a problem in ADCS because the difference is too small for the control loop for a controller. There we can see the two kinds of magnetometers. One, the most reliable magnetometer is that is based in inductive technology and not the MEMS with resistive. And we can see that it's aligned to each other. It goes together. And in the other diagram, we can see the difference between the values of magnetometers. Again? Okay. GPS and in orbit never got fixed position, and that is a problem because never produce a TLE to run the determination algorithm of a DCS. Let's see about the gyroscopes and temperature. We can see that the blue one is the angular velocity of x-axis. That means in the x-axis we have a continuous rotation about 0.4, 0.3 degrees per second. And that is the reason that we didn't have a valid sun sensor measurement because of continuous x-axis rotation. So we didn't have any sun sensor measurement in order to analyze it if it works. Let's talk about the actuators. We can see this fluctuation of spin torque that can show us about the continuous rotation of x-axis. And also we can see about the spin torque that the first measurement is near to launch day. So we can see that at first, and also the x-axis has a continuous rotation, but after we can see also from gyroscope that the y-axis, which is the red one, is very stable due to spin torque rotation, which is near to 500 after the middle of mission. So, some results. Some good practices. I think that is to pay attention to the control strategy modes and how they alternate between pointing and doubling. Maybe a suggestion is to change the controller from doubling to pointing mode with a ground command. Yes. More time for development, testing, and code review. Maybe a ground also command is to feed the satellite with TLE by the ground due to possible issues with GPS, like the UPSat. If in the QB50 mission, we cannot add the ADCS health status in the simple wall orbit data. So that's the reason that we have only 8 packets for ADCS. And about hardware things, use different bus for different communication bus for actuators and sensors. And again, about testing of determination algorithm with instrumentation and control algorithms with instrumentation. Here we can find the source files about UPSat, and that's it.
That was really great. Great to hear some results. I just wanted to ask one thing before anyone else jumps in. In your abstract, you talk about making this an open call for open source software and hardware development of testing tools for ADCS.
Because I don't have a lot of time to...
Yeah.
So, and open instrumentation. It's an open call to to start developing things about how to test, to build test instrumentation about the EDCS, like a gimbal or a Helmholtz coil cage, and an air bearing, for example, in order to start testing without using commercial available testing tools. And this means that we can start to build a simulator about it that control the cage, the coil cage, with, for example, by control the produce the magnetic field of the Earth in the orbit in, with the cages. That's it. Yeah, part of the loop. And okay, that's it.
Okay. More Thank questions you. From the audience? Whoa, okay.
Could you provide us more information about the sun sensor and the magnetotorquer, please?
Okay.
or a little.
Sun sensor is developed by SSBV, a company in South Africa, and is a fine sun sensor. I don't remember the field of view, and also it's placed in one side of the satellite, in the Z minus, and as I remember, the documentation about the sun sensor is too poor, I think, because it gives us an algorithm to calculate the exactly yeah the two angles of the sun, and as I remember, it has a wrong in data sheet in how to calculate how to convert the ADC values. It has the sun sensor is an analog sensor. You measure four channels of with ADC and convert four voltages into the angles of in body frame of the sun. So a suggestion about it is maybe it's better to use core sun sensors in each side, because if you have a continuous rotation, for example, in X axis, maybe the sun sensor is not so useful in one side, a fine sun sensor in fine, yeah.
Okay, thanks. I think we would have time for one more question, but not for the answer.
Okay.
So, if you have a burning question.
But no answer.
That's it? Okay.
Yeah. Okay, great. Thank you.